Hello, musicians. Thanks for joining us. My name is Andrew Mercer, and I'm going to be doing a short tutorial today on how to save a file in Audacity, how to save a project. But more importantly, I'm going to address an issue that's come up with a lot of my subscribers, and that's why is it that sometimes they save projects but can't open them later? So I'm going to address that. Okay, so first of all, you notice here that we have Audacity open. I'm going to record a little... I'm going to record a little track here. Check one, two, three. Check one, two, three. Blah, 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 blah. I'm going to record track another here. Track.
Check one, two, all right, three.
Let's check two. Let's do track three.
Track
I'm going to
well.
Record another
this
track.
Not meant to be good.
This is just meant to be some tracks for us. So we've got a bunch of noise here now.
Track
I'm
going
to record another track. There you go. So now I'm going to go file. I'm going to save project. Now, when you're working on a project, you save the project. You don't do an export. Because an export is going to produce a piece of sound for you, like a MP3 or a WAV file. And that's good if you're finished the project, but if you're in the middle of the project and you've got slider settings that you want to change and you got different tracks and you're doing a mix and you want to be able to continue working on it, you really want a project. That's what you need to save it as. So save project. And you see here it gives me, I'm going to save it on the desktop, so let's call this Andrew. And let's save it. And if you notice here, the format's going to be .AUP. That's an Audacity project file. All right, I'm going to click save and it saves it. Now, what you'll notice here, you'll see here on the desktop, it saved andrew.aup and it saved a folder called andrew_data. Now, these have to be kept together. If you separate these, if you take the AUP file and you save it in a different folder, or if you email it to somebody, or you move it away somewhere, it won't be able to find the data folder. It's very important that the data folder and the AUP file stay together. Let me just demonstrate. If I close my file and I click it again, it opens it up perfectly. But if I just create a new little folder here, let's say create a folder and call it testing. Oops, well, let's leave it as untitled folder. And I've moved my AUP file into there, and I open it. There's the AUP file, but again, I've just moved it, so if I try to open it, I'm going to get an error. Look at this. It's here, project detected 3 missing data blocks, so it won't work. Okay, that won't work. So, but if I take my file, I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to take my file, I'm going to move it back out, and put it back with my, back on my desktop with my, there you go, back where it's supposed to be. And I double-click it now, it'll open it up because now it found the data folder again. So you can't go moving around these two files separately. You need to move them together. So if you did need to move it to another folder, move it together, please. And that should keep you fine. If you want to email the file to somebody, or if you want to upload it to a website or something like that, you can't send the .AUP file. It won't work. You need to export it as a WAV file or an MP3 or something else and send it then. Sending the .AUP file will not work. The person on the other end will not be able to open it. Okay, very important. So, you know what? That's basically it for saving project files. There's not much else to it. Again, if you want to export it as an MP3 or a WAV, you would have to do the export feature. And we have another video here, tutorial, to show you how to do that. Okay, if you guys have, if you like this, if this worked for you, please give me a thumbs up. Give me a like, if subscribe. And you know what? This question came from subscribers. So please, if you have a question, put it down in the comments below, and I will do my best. I'll do my best to answer it for you. You know, and there's probably a dozen other people with the same question. So, you know, you're not alone. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.